Hello there, everyone. So this video is kind of weird because it's technically me from the future, I guess. So my videos right now are like all the way back in August, and it's December. So if that kind of gives you some indication on how bad I've been with just putting things out there. This is Ollie. Pretty sure he was in my last video. This is Oliver, my cat. This video is just gonna be me talking about my experience in CGS and kind of like how I was in high school, which won't be like the best indicator of how I got in because nobody really knows why they get in places, I feel. But I'm just gonna say my own experience, and then hopefully that will help you compare. I feel like it's helpful to hear about other people, so this is me. We'll start with how I was in high school. So basically I took like all the honors classes I could. I'm pretty sure I took all honors classes, and throughout my high school career I took 6 APs, and they were like all different APs. I took English, history, science, and math APs. My GPA was a 4.1, but it doesn't really make much sense because my school scale is technically out of a 4.0, but if you take APs, you get like extra, I don't know, it's like extra credit, I guess. Your GPA ends up being like higher just because you took an AP, so that doesn't mean that I had like a 4.0, like I didn't have the highest. Like, I knew people who had like 4.5s. It's somewhere in the middle. I would say like on a normal 4.0 scale, I probably had like a mid to high 3, like in the 3s, but like mid to high, like 3.5 to definitely not 4.0, but you know, somewhere around there. This might be more helpful, but I was kind of an A/B+ student. Usually my report cards would be like half and half, like 4 A's and 3 B's, but the thing is, like, the classes I would get B's in were my APs, which kind of sort of translates to an A. So that's just really complicated, but that's just kind of how I was. I was always like an A, B student. My SATs were not the best. I had very, very average SATs, and that's really just because I don't tend to like retain things very well unless it was something that I was like really interested in and like passionate about. That makes test taking very hard, obviously. So my SAT was a 1240 or a 1260, I forget which one. Very average, at least to me that's average. I don't exactly know what is like low, average, high for an SAT, but to me that just sounds like a pretty average score. What I think happened is that what I did not make up for in grades, I definitely made up for in after school activities. So in every school activity I was in, I had a leadership position. So my senior year, for example, I was like secretary, vice president, and captain of 3 different clubs, like French club, mock trial, and National Honor Society. So that definitely shows that you're like kind of going above and beyond in those areas, and just shows that you're like very heavily involved. You can be a leader, which like obviously colleges are always looking for. Yeah, so I thought that is really important, like when it comes to academics and things you do outside of school, it's really important to be well-rounded. And I know like your high school always tells you this, but it actually is really important, something you should keep in mind. If you do lack in academics, you can definitely make up for with your extracurriculars, because it provides like an excuse for why your grades might not be that great, because you spend so much time doing other also really important things, because academics are definitely not everything when it comes to just doing well in school or getting into college. And I definitely wasn't involved in stuff all 4 years. I would say I honestly can't remember anything else that I was involved in high school. There might have been just one or two things, and I didn't do those things for all 4 years. So French club, I only did for 2 years, like junior, senior, mock trial, I started sophomore year. in National Honor Society. It starts junior year, so I'm pretty sure I was very, like, either not involved at all or very loosely involved in freshman year and sophomore year. So I always heard before that your junior and senior year are the ones that, like, colleges look at more and pay more attention to. And I would say that's true because I really didn't do anything my first 2 years of high school besides work. That's even another thing. Well, it's not like something you're doing in your community, like volunteering or like something for your school. That also I think is helpful because it shows that you kind of have a life outside of school and you're making money, which is something that shows that you're responsible, I think. So now to the application process. BU had always been my number one, even in middle school, like without even knowing what BU really was. Like, I was like, I'm going to BU, that's where I want to go, because it was in Boston and it was a university, and I put those two words together and I was like, yeah, that's where I want to go. So I've always loved Boston a lot. Came time to apply, there's this little check mark, I forget where, but on the application there's a little check mark, a little check button, and it says like, would you like to be considered for like the Boston London program? And I checked that, having no idea what it was, because I was like, anything that will improve my chances of getting here, I want to do. And it didn't like reason with me that the word London was in there. I didn't really think about the consequences of my actions. I was just like, I'm doing it, because I think part of me didn't really think I was gonna get it anyway, so I was just like, whatever, we're just gonna take this chance. So I checked it. So that's like step number one. If you want to get into the CGS program, you have to click that, because it shows that you're interested and you want to be considered. What you have to keep in mind is that if you press that and you get into CGS, you can't opt out of CGS. I don't know if that's changed since I first applied, but that's how it is. Like, you get into that program, you cannot just decide not to be in that program. So it's either, if you get accepted, it's either CGS or you don't go to BU. Something I do think helped me too is that there's this one paragraph that you have to write about why you want to go to BU. I think that was it. It was like, why do you want to come here? And I remember I had gone to this meeting. I didn't go to a tour. I went to this thing thinking it was a tour, and it wasn't. It was more of like kind of a meeting, like application tips, what we're looking for kind of thing. And they were like, don't talk about the city. They were like, do not say that it's because you want to be in Boston, because there are plenty of other schools, which is so true. I looked at the study abroad programs because I knew that that was something I definitely wanted to do. And I ended up just picking a random one and talking about it. Don't like go into depth, but... Or I didn't go into depth, but I was like, yeah, I want to travel. I've always wanted to travel. I know I want to study abroad. BU has a lot of study abroad programs, something like that. And I definitely think that helped me, because obviously I said that I wanted to travel. So when they were considering me, they were probably like, oh, this would be great for her. She wants to travel. And these people go to London. That's one thing. If you really want to get into CGS, I would recommend putting something about travel in that paragraph. To be honest with y'all, I don't exactly know why they choose CGS students and why they don't choose I don't really know why. That's kind of something that they don't really explain, but I did put travel in there, so it totally makes sense to me why they chose me. At first I was like kind of upset, because I was like, are you kidding? I'm gonna start in January and all my friends are gonna start in September. I'm gonna feel left out. But honestly, I would do it again in a heartbeat. It was the best thing I ever did, because I got all that time to just like relax after a really, really hard senior year. And I got to work and save up so much money. And I pretty much did whatever I wanted in London because I had all my savings. So it was a really good time to just kind of like find yourself and experience what it's like not to be in school. You get that really long break. And when you come, and then you gotta go to London in the summer, which is like crazy. It's a once in a lifetime experience for some people. And I never thought I'd be going to Europe like so early on in my life. And it's a 6 week semester. So basically half of a semester, and it counts for a full one. So like, why wouldn't you do it? Like, that's amazing. And you graduate at the same time as everyone else. You pretty much, at least I did, paid the same that I would have paid in a normal semester, And, you know, that's including flights, including living in London, including, like, everything, pretty much everything in a normal semester. And besides food, that's something to talk about. The place where you're staying at has kitchens, and you buy your own groceries, and you get to cook your own food, which is great. It really was not an issue. Most people enjoyed getting to cook, and, you know, you get to, like, have these little kitchen get together party things with your friends and just make food. And it ended up being so nice because the kitchen was actually a place for bonding, for sure. I feel like 50% of our time in London was in the kitchen, and I wish I was exaggerating, but no, I'm kidding. Maybe, I don't know. All I know is that it was a huge amount of time in the kitchen. Like, most people were barely, I feel like, at least me, I was barely in my room. I was mostly in the kitchen when I was in the building. So an application process tip in general, I would say visit the school if you can, because colleges do want to see that you took interest in going to see what the school is like, and just having enough interest to go visit it, for sure. And I don't recommend applying to a place that you have never visited, because that's going to be a place that you're going to be spending a lot of your time at, and, you know, living there if you plan to live on campus. So I knew some people who did not visit, and they ended up choosing a school and hating it once they did visit. So don't do that. That's a really bad idea. As far as the spring semester goes, like, not London, but January, that was great, because you get to really build a relationship with your professors, and you're gonna notice in your other non-CGS classes that's not a thing that happens. Like, most professors don't know your name. You don't get to talk to them, really, unless you go to office hours. But with your CGS professors, it's like a friendship. It's like a teacher and also a friend. And at least on my team, like, I noticed that my professors, like, genuinely cared about me and what was going on in my life and how I was doing and how I was feeling. The workload is fine. It's really a lot like high school. It's a lot of reading, a lot of papers. It's all liberal arts, really. Like I said, you graduate at the same time as everyone else, really, unless you are a major which requires more time. Like, I'm in physical therapy, for example, so either way I'm gonna have to go to grad school. But as far as my bachelor's goes, I'm graduating in 2022, the same time I would have if I was not in CGS. It is a little bit frustrating sometimes when you're taking classes that you feel aren't for your major, but CGS classes cover even more credits than a regular gen ed would, so you're really just doing more at once. If you don't enjoy the content you're learning, you're not necessarily gonna feel that way. Personally, like, writing is not my strong suit. I don't really like writing, so the first semester was, and London, because London is mostly writing. It's like all writing and reading. But if you are like me, where that's not really your thing, it's gonna be a little tough, but it wasn't impossible. Like I said, it was much like high school. It was manageable. And it's fun to make friends, because the people that are on the same team as you, the same CGS team, they have all the same classes as you. So, like, same lectures. The people in your discussion are gonna be the people in your lecture. So that was cool, because you see these people repeatedly and it's much easier to make friends with them rather than having like four different classes. As far as the summer semester goes, I can make a whole different thing out of that, because I feel like I have a lot more to say on that. But basically, it was hard, I'm not gonna lie, but it was hard for everyone. I don't think anyone really was like, yeah, that was the easiest thing I've ever done. It was hard because you're in a different country, you want to explore, most people have not been before, you want to just, like, get the most out of the 6 weeks you possibly can. And honestly, I would 100%, 1000% recommend, this is going to sound so bad, but put your experience before your classes while not ruining a good thing. Like, do not fail, do not get bad grades, but it sounds very bad, but what I mean by that is, like, if you think that putting hours and hours and hours and stress and anxiety into a paper to get an A plus, but you can go out with your friends that night instead and maybe not put as much work into a paper and get like a B plus, get the B plus, because when is there gonna be another time when you're with 80, I don't know, I think for me it was 80. I think now the program is growing and it's gonna be way more than that, but when do you get to be with a bunch of other college kids in a different country who are like all people that you already knew before and you're really good friends with most of them and you're in a different country and you get to explore and do whatever you want? When is that gonna happen? Like, a lot of people don't get the chance to study abroad because, you know, there's an application process and an approval process and the money is involved too. Like, a lot of people don't get this experience if you have to choose between a perfect score or a good score and an average score. Get the average score and, you know, go out and explore, because, like, it's an amazing opportunity. I'm home right now, and what I can remember, it was hard, but what I can remember was the awesome times I had and, like, the risks I took, like, the friendships I made, the places I went. I don't remember what grades I got on what assignments. That stuff isn't gonna matter after. It's like the memories that you made, and I don't know about you, but I don't wanna come back from a 6 week long trip in Europe regretting that I didn't go out more and regretting that I didn't see this and see that over a paper. Like, I don't wanna remember me at a desk writing paper. I wanna remember going out and having fun. That's luckily what I do remember, because I had a list going into there and I did almost everything on that list. And yeah, sure, there were one or two things that I didn't get to do, but I got to do a lot and I got to do most of what I wanted to do. So I totally do not regret that at all. I can make up, I've had in that time 3 more years to make up those grades, and you know, I'm doing fine now. So I don't regret it. I don't regret it. I would do it again in a heartbeat. It was so hard. Tears were shed all around, but so was laughter and smiles and positivity. It was great. And your teachers are, I didn't hear of a bad experience with a teacher. Your professors are really understanding. And I know that all of my professors gave me so much undeserved grace and just mercy. And it was amazing. My professors were amazing. But yeah, they know you're college kids and you're in a different country and you're here to have a good time. They understand. Like, you know, they're still professors. They still have to be firm with you sometimes, but they're going to be nice about it. You know, they're going to be lenient. And I don't know what I would have done if my professors had been like super just awful, and I don't know. I could not have done it without the amazingness of my professors, for sure. But like I said, I can talk more about that. Yeah, so if you have any questions or anything I didn't cover, just feel free to ask. I would love to do this again, because I feel like I have so much to say. Like, I just have to remember everything, and then I can just talk about this for hours. Yeah, I think that is it. Hope you enjoyed. Have a great day, night, whatever it is over there.